love that I get to have a little influence on the crew here. And, you know,
not as big as your crew.
Well, I don't expect you to do that overnight, but it's nice for you guys.
We'll get there. Hopefully by season two, we'll have a crew as big as yours.
You know what? I kind of miss the old setup when it was just Oscar there and I could just yell at him and it wasn't so much pressure. So it's kind of nice. Enjoy these moments.
And now you've been including Mike in a lot of the episodes.
I've included Mike in one episode. There was actually two, but the first one failed. And
because Mike was there?
Mm-hmm. Because we had to scrap it.
Wait, why did it fail?
It was a tense environment. Mike didn't understand his position on the show, and he tried to do more than what I was asking for, and he ruined the episode.
That's absolutely not what happened.
He ruined it. Everyone hated him.
He had a little hissy fit right before the shoot because Oscar made a comment that he didn't like, and we had to all calm Jeff down because he was like, I'm not doing the shoot.
Well, I like fairness, I like to keep my environment very uncomfortable and tense. I know normally on a talk show set, they'd probably like to make people feel good and comfortable and have them open up. I like to do the opposite.
So when it's flipped around on you, though, and you feel tense, that's when you get upset.
That's when I get upset, yeah, because I like to be in control, and I felt disrespected, and Mike was not helping the situation by his little snarky comments that he throws in there. You know how it gets.
Well, no, I feel like Mike lives well on your show. For me, my temper would hit the roof and I'd be out of there within the first 10 minutes.
But you were good on the episode. I think you played yourself really well.
I think I did too, but I want to go back and maybe redeem myself.
Oh, you want to do a sequel?
I mean, I would like to.
Okay, I can get you in there for sure.
You think so?
Sometime in March, yeah.
Are you already fully booked until March?
Fully booked, yeah.
Wow.
Fully booked, but we might have some cancellations in March. It's good to see you guys stepping it up over here. I hope you guys did a better job on your research and your preparation for me this time around, because we got cameras. This will live on YouTube, I'm guessing, right?
Yeah.
Last time you did a real shit job. You showed up hungover. No disrespect. I'm just telling the truth here. I'm a real guy here. I know we just met. You're new here, but I tell the truth. That's why people come to me.
But you were such a good guest.
Yeah, we were not.
You were such a good guest.
We had a great time with you.
You were such a good guest that was, I feel like, the moment after your episode when Zane and Heath kicked me off of Unfiltered.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I forgot about that. Matt the Rat, boycott Unfiltered.
But I still love Unfiltered. No, still listen to them. I just wish I was still on it.
No, I'm kidding. I love those guys.
Jeff, why are you wearing the glasses today?
I know people are going to jump to conclusions and say, oh, it's because his eye. My eyes are fine. I just know your audience is probably a bunch of haters, so they're probably going to want to find something to talk shit about anyway.
That's your audience. We have nice people that leave nice comments.
I got roasted nonstop in the comments.
I know, and they're going to do that to me here. They're
going to say, Jeff, this is hot stuff. If it just gets in your head, do you read comments?
I read them, yeah, because I listen to my fans.
Okay.
I care about their opinion. I don't just look at them like a statistic like you guys.
You think we view our fans as statistics?
Uh-huh.
I mean, we actually go in and respond to the fans. We like the comments.
I talk to all my fans.
No, all you do is say, if Mike sucks, leave a like, and that's all. that's your involvement.
Bro,
with the fans.
I had the best... it was my personal favorite episode of all time. We worked very hard on it. We planned the story, the whole metaphor of me never existing and being a figment of Todd's imagination. I love this episode. And Mike said in the episode, and somehow it made the cut, that leave a dislike if you want
Jonah to be the co-host.
Yeah, if you want Jonah
to be the co-host. And leave a like if you want Mike to be the co-host.
Bro, they listened to him, and I got bombed with dislikes. I had like 10,000 dislikes on the video.
No, you didn't.
Yeah, I had to go in YouTube and cut it out.
There's like 62,000 likes because they want me as the official co-host.
No, bro. Bro, he fucking bombed my video. Again, the second one. The first one was okay, I get it. It's his first time. It's okay. And the second time he sabotaged me, I'm done with him. I'm done. And I'm just here to let everybody know that Mike is done. Don't leave dislikes on the video. Go watch it. Go leave an extra like on it. Make another account. Make bot accounts and go watch it because this is my favorite episode of all time, the Halloween Fight Club one.
Jeff, how are you? How are you feeling?
I'm good, man. I'm doing much better. These past few months have been hard. I don't want to get into it. I don't want to talk about that stuff. I haven't done any podcasts or any interviews since my accident, and I will start talking about that stuff when the time comes, but today we're just going to talk about how I hate you guys, but actually, I do like you guys a lot because we're able to joke around with each other,
yeah.
So that means a lot.
Oh, I was reading something the other day about a guy who just escaped prison and he like filmed the entire thing. Did you see that?
No.
Okay, well, this dude like filmed his whole escape from prison. How hard is it to escape from prison? Like, do you think you could pull it off?
No.
Did you ever talk to like any other fellow inmates? Like a plan?
No, fuck no.
No? It's not even worth it?
No. Even if you have like a felony or like a warrant in this country, there's no point of trying to run. They'll find you and they will extradite you back and they will get you. Like,
even if you're innocent and you escape prison, do...
Like, this isn't the movies, bro. Like, it's 2020. That's why I do YouTube now and I'm not like dabbling in illegal crime activity anymore.
Yeah, you know? Right. Mm-hmm. Do you think you would ever run as an elected official?
First of all, I'm a felon.
Can you not run?
I think you
I can't even vote.
You can't vote?
No.
Shit, that's fucked.
Oh, I'm sorry, Jeff.
I don't give a shit. Well, whatever, I just
voted on that proposition, that I think inmates should be allowed to vote.
Thank you, felons. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Yeah, I did vote for that proposition.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Maybe one day.
People.
Are you nervous?
It's a little weird. I'm driving around. Driving here, I saw a bunch of stores getting boarded up.
Right.
Really?
Yeah, all over. Every store. It's nuts drilling these boards in. That's what I don't understand, though. Like, if you're a looter, why don't you just get a power drill and just take out the screw, you know? And then you smash right in. Really, like, what is the board really saving? You know, it's not a hurricane. It's not, like, weather.
Yeah.
Like, you got criminals want to get in, they'll get in.
I think it just kind of swerves their attempt from, like, considering that building. It just puts up a barrier.
Yeah,
right?
It's true.
Your Crazy. Body's looking great, Jeff.
Is it? Thank you.
I think your this last video might be the best looking your body's ever been.
Really?
Yeah.
But were you doing like push-ups in between takes?
No.
Making sure he's keeping those abs nice and crisp, doing some crunches.
I was in a near-death accident, and I wasn't able to work out for a long time. So finally, now that I got back, like this past month, I'm able to finally work out again. And I went hard. Like this past month, I was dieting, cryotherapy, sauna, runyon every day. Like I really took it serious for first time in a while.
You have a good like bicep pump right now.
I think
your arms have been the biggest I've seen them in a while.
I'm just an athlete, Matt. I really pride myself being an athlete first and an influencer and whatever you want to call me, content creator afterwards. First comes first. I spend 4 hours training martial arts every day.
Mixed martial arts, everything.
Every single one.
Jiu-jitsu,
Hapkido, Taekwondo, mm-hmm. MMA.
Yeah, Kung Fu. I'm doing it all.
Tai Chi.
That's why I'm late right now. My Kung Fu classes went overboard. 40 minutes.
What belt are you right now in karate?
Black.
Black.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, what Three is your ninjas. Kung Fu classes? It's just watching.
Self-taught.
Self-taught? Mm-hmm. You have like a virtual like instructor? Or you're just watching a YouTube guy?
Both.
Both?
Yes.
Okay. Could you break this table?
You're looking a lot at the biceps. I could smash the shit out of this table right now.
You think so?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You want me to do it? You guys have to take a couple
don't
weeks off
the don't
podcast.
Don't break the table.
Took you long enough to get this going.
I mean,
to smash it up.
The video wasn't necessary. We were doing real good on the audio.
Yeah?
Yeah. Yeah. Loved it, right?
Oh, yeah. You were great on audio.
Are you guys giving Heath and Zane a run for their money?
See, I don't view my friends as competition.
I do.
We're a family.
That's why,
here.
That's
You're
why
very
I'm doing so well.
Because
I'm driven. I'm coming for all of you guys.
Who's your dream guest that you want to have on the barbershop?
I had them all already.
Oh,
really?
I
don't even think about it.
You don't have any other more dreams or aspirations? Everyone else is just down. Well, who did it peak as?
I'd like to do a Cody Co. repeat sequel. That's a dream guest of mine. I want to make amends with him.
I was just talking to Cody a few days ago. He said yes to doing this podcast, and Kelsey said yes. And did he say anything about you?
Yeah.
Didn't bring you up once.
No?
No.
Dude. There's like this new vibe that he gets when he's like in weird Jeff mode.
Uh-huh.
And the fact that you just said that Cody's going to come on this before he goes back on the barbershop, I think just made him real mad. And I'm like actually nervous.
I think Cody's going to be on this before he comes back on your barbershop.
Nice. It's nice. I'm happy for you.
Yeah. Jeff, I just want to say congratulations.
Thank you. For what?
You got nominated for a Streamy.
Oh,
for Best Unscripted Series for your barbershop.
Yeah. Thank you.
Who are you going up against?
I am going up against some big dogs, some big fish. James Charles is going to be tough, but he's always in some controversies and no stranger to that. Like, he has been accused of a lot of stuff. I don't want to get into it, but...
And you're a clean cut.
I'm clean, yeah. And everything I've done in the past is out there.
Okay.
But the stuff that is surfacing about James Charles is very real, and I think we should bring attention to it. I don't know if you want to do it here, but he has been accused of supporting terrorism.
Bullshit. Mm-hmm. Really?
I wasn't sure if I wanted to talk about this yet, but when the nominations came out, I met up with him to talk with him, and he grabbed me right on my penis. He grabbed a hold of it, and he said, if you don't drop out of the runnings, I'm going to rip this off.
Have you had him on your barbershop, though?
No, not yet. Have I you asked him? I asked him to come on, but he said probably said no because I say things like that.
If he wins, will you still have him on?
If he wins, I won't accept it.
You won't accept the results of the election? Right.
Nope.
How do the streamies work? Is it like the Academy? Or
is it fan voting?
Fan voted.
Like, good question.
Should we direct people to go and vote for you?
I don't want it to come off like a threat, but yeah, you guys should go vote for me. Otherwise, there's going to be hell to pay if I don't win. There's going to be a shitstorm at those awards.
Right. But the thing is, like, you're being categorized as unscripted, but yours is completely scripted, right?
No.
No. Wow, Jeff's in the hot seat.
It's unscripted.
It is unscripted.
It's in the right category. Okay. I think everybody else is that's in that category doesn't deserve to be there.
Jonah, Scott, Vardon, Mike Sheffer. Who is your favorite part-time co-host on The Barbershop and why?
Vardon, by a landslide. Vardon was great.
It's okay. It's okay.
And I'll be honest, sometimes those episodes are tough to film. They're really hard because the energy there, everybody hates being there. It feels like I got a bunch of hostages behind my cameras, and it's been tough. Vardon was the best. Vardon brought joy into he changed my mood, and I wish I could have him there all the time, but unfortunately, he's 13, he has school, and he's not prepared to be a full-time co-host, and also Jonah gets jealous. It wouldn't be right if I replaced him in his own house with his younger brother that's cooler and more love than him. So I'll just have him temporarily there. I like having everybody kind of pop in and out. It just keeps it fun, and the whole barbershop vibe is there's people in and out all the time. There's some guys that hang out in barbershops all day that just talk shit, and like you don't know what they do or whatever. So that could be like your position, just a guy that just comes by and nobody likes him, but you do kind of like him, you know?
Mike, you're like a brother to me, man.
Yeah, you're a family.
Like, I couldn't imagine doing this with anyone else but Mike Sheffer. Mm-hmm. Like,
yeah, and I don't need you there anymore. I'm not even kidding.
I mean, I think Matt should go back on soon, though.
But I've been considering, like, should I dye my hair?
Yeah, I got a specialist that's on the team now. She joined the team, the girl Megan. She's very sweet. She's good. And it's nice having somebody there to actually do the hair. I don't even want to do the hair anymore on the show.
You just want to be the host?
I just want to be the host, yeah.
Oh, so you get like an apprentice to actually do the haircuts, and then you just act like a psychopath for 45 minutes.
Yeah, that's my dream shoot. Yeah, that'd be perfect. Vardon co-hosting, I don't have to cut the hair.
Where's all the hair go after the episode? Like, are you putting like Noah Beck's hair up on eBay after?
That's a good idea. So I did that on Josh Peck early on, and it was bad because they were like talking about like you can't sell people's hair without their permission because like you could use it to frame people on a scene of a crime. Say like you were murdered here one night, and like I put like Mike's hair there, you know, like it looks like Mike killed you. Like,
oh, I was thinking more like voodoo-esque stuff, though.
Yeah, do you believe in that?
Do you?
No.
I feel like you don't believe in any supernatural stuff.
No, I just started believing in aliens recently.
You just started? Yeah. You had a lot of doubt that of there being other life form out there besides us.
I didn't believe it. Yeah, I didn't believe it until I
What did you base that on?
Joe Rogan said it at Post Malone.
Joe Rogan's pretty curious about aliens, right?
Yeah, Post Malone was on and they had like a 4-hour conversation about
it. Oh yeah, I did like that episode though.
Yeah, that's what convinced you?
Yeah, when I heard Joe Rogan talking about it with a couple smart guys, I was like, you know what? They got to be out there. What was I thinking all these years? I even made a song about it after that.
You made a song about aliens?
Yeah, my Burning Man verse was about how Joe Rogan changed my opinion on aliens.
Yeah, it was a landmark verse in the hip-hop community. I read about it in Rolling Stone magazine, actually.
It was just a quick thing. It was what was going through my mind at the time, and I just spit it out. And then we just recently recorded another song at the end of my barbershop.
What's the name of it?
It was a cover of Where's My Mind.
Oh, by the Pixies.
Yeah.
Because it was a Fight Club.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Where's Todd's Mind?
Oh, wow.
Yeah, just doing music stuff, you know.
You're going to write a book next? What else are you going to copy from Todd's career? Is Todd your best friend in the world?
I have a lot of friends that people don't even know about. There's a whole side of me that people don't even know on the internet. They think they know Jeff from the vlog squad. He's probably over there hanging out with Matt and Zane.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's all just for the cameras. It's all just bullshit. I make up this whole facade.
How's your love life going?
Non-existent.
Non-existent?
No. Nope.
Not talking to anyone?
No. And you know what? I don't like something. I don't know if I should talk about it here. Actually, no, fuck it.
Wait. You don't want to talk about it? Why not?
I heard, now, like I said earlier, I'm in touch with my fans. I talk to them. I heard that David said on Views, Jeff's always showing me pictures of chicks he's nailing and stuff like that. And that's completely false. I haven't even talked to David in 6 months. And he said that Jeff and Zane show me all the girls they fuck. That's
Zane?
Zane? What's your type?
I just like a girl that has like her own dreams, her own like goals, and she's working towards it and knows what she wants.
Right.
Because it's tough to find. I think that's what I liked about my ex. She had her own career. She didn't fall into the bullshit. Followed the plan. She knew the vision and she just followed it. You know, like us. Look at us. We don't know what the fuck we're doing. We're trying to podcast for a little bit.
Yeah.
We are supported by HelloFresh. HelloFresh is America's number one meal kit. They deliver pre-measured ingredients and mouth-watering seasonal recipes straight to your door. It makes cooking fun, affordable, stress-free for the entire family. I've been using HelloFresh for about a few years now before they've sponsored this episode, so it's awesome getting to tell you guys about it. Like I said, it's stress-free, no contact delivery, straight to your door, and you don't have to make any more trips to the grocery store. You don't have to cry unless you're chopping up onions. But and what's also great is it helps you eat more sustainably. All of the packaging materials are made from recycled or pre-recycled materials. And they're also committed to giving back. I love working with a company that really does care. So far in 2020, they've given over 3.5 million meals to families in need. Have you used HelloFresh?
Of course, yeah.
What's your favorite recipe?
I like the vegetarian options because I'm a vegetarian, but everything they have is delicious.
It is. I'm really excited about the recipes they have coming up. I'm going to be cooking them with Zane. One of them in particular is the sweet chili pork bowls. Ooh, I'm so excited to hit my kitchen and get to cooking. Last time I cooked with Zane, though, it was super convenient and quick. And not only did it fill our bellies, it filled our confidence when it comes to cooking. And that's why I love HelloFresh. So if you guys are new to HelloFresh and want to give it a shot, go to HelloFresh.com/Hoot90 and use the code Hoot90 for $90 off and free shipping on your first order. Once again, that's HelloFresh.com/Hoot90. Use the code Hoot90 and you'll get $90 off with free shipping on your first order of HelloFresh. Give it a shot. Make cooking affordable, stress-free, and convenient with HelloFresh.
You know, something crazy that happened. I don't know if I could say this here, but actually, yeah, fuck it. What's the big deal? So the Burning Man song.
Yeah.
We did like a little skit in the beginning. And Simon Rex, yeah, the guy we did the song with, Dirt Nasty. He's like a legend in Hollywood, like just the people he knows. It's so weird. Like you never know who's watching your stuff when you put something out on the internet.
Right.
And Todd Phillips texted Simon that like he loved the Burning Man song.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
Todd Phillips, the director of The Hangover and a lot of
other things. Yeah, no, I remember when you like texted the group with that screenshot.
Yeah.
I was like, what?
And he quoted Jonah's verse. Like he said, my name's Nick and I suck my own dick. And it's just crazy that he was watching our stupid video that I never thought anybody like with a brain would fucking actually like this. Right. But turns out Todd Phillips is a big fan of Simon and Jonah. And I guess it's just cool that he watched it, you know? So maybe Todd Phillips will watch this now.
Yeah.
If you're lucky.
If you're lucky.
Yeah, you're right.
Who was the last person you punched in the face and why?
You.
That was a slap. That was a little bit of a bitch slap.
It was a slap, but there was real violence in that video, which I was very, very stern. I wanted to get that I wanted real shit to happen in that video. But yeah, I was happy that you came there and you took those slaps and you slapped Jonah. You made some of your own real violence. That was nice.
I've never punched anybody in the face.
Really?
No.
Punch Mike right now.
No.
No.
What? Just do it. Live a little.
No.
The episode's over, Jeff.
When you punch someone in the face, is it like this way? Like, or do you do a hook? Or do you just like jab up? Or
so you want to come, you want to punch with those two knuckles. I learned the hard way and I broke these multiple times.
Oof.
See how they're smashed in and my fists look different?
Okay.
Because my right hook was too powerful for my bones. So I broke this hand several times.
Okay.
And being a barber, you never want to break your hand because then you have a cast and you can't cut hair anymore. You can't work.
Right.
So you have to find other sources of income. What do? You're a 15-year-old kid with a broken hand. no job in Staten Island, what are you going to resort to?
Work at a hotel?
Yeah. You're going to buy an ounce of weed, and you're going to break it up into dime bags, and you're going to sell that to your customers now because you can't give them haircuts. At least sell them weed. So that's what that caused. That's a little series of events. Make that a little storyline.
So it's like a daily reminder for you.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah. Yeah. You got to survive. You got to keep eating. If you don't know how to throw a punch properly, you know, you could break your hand and then you got to sell drugs.
Yeah. Because you're basically just sending energy to the end point, which if this end point is not fully tight, then this is going to take the hit. But you want to send the energy through to the person. So mm-hmm. this needs to be just as tight as the rest of you.
I'm sorry.
Am I wrong?
But I love seeing this like side of you. Who was the last person you punched?
I've never been like in an actual fight. I mean, obviously done sparring and boxing and stuff growing up, but I got punched in the face one time when I was 11 and then vowed to never get punched in the face
who
again.
Who punched you?
These like skateboard kids that were like bothering my younger brother. What?
Skateboard kids.
Yeah, they were. They were like,
okay,
yeah.
Nobody gives a fuck about this shit.
I'm curious.
Let's talk about it. Let's talk about unfiltered. You parting ways with them. What happened? Who's in the right? Who's in the wrong?
What happened was one day I came home. Heath and Zane said, we need to talk to you about something. And they said, we're really proud of you. We've loved having you on Unfiltered. And we're really happy that you're starting your own podcast. We just feel like it's best now that we go our separate ways.
They said, you're stepping on our toes.
I guess so. It was tough, but I have to respect their decision. One thing though that I just want to clear up is I think right now there's a lot of people, because I've read like on comments and stuff like, oh, why is Matt not on Unfiltered? And a lot of people seem to think that I like left
you
them
to go
on
solo.
My own will
yeah.
to do this. Mm-hmm. The thing is, I thought I could do both. Like, because a lot of comedians have like, oh, a group podcast together and they go off and have their own individual ones. The thing is, they also wanted to expand and have guests on similar to what I'm doing. But that's it. But I say that with like love. I respect their decision. I still avidly support and watch Unfiltered. Mm-hmm.
But it was after your episode, actually, that this happened. Yeah. So maybe you're the root cause of this, Jeff. You got to fix
maybe this will start some more stuff. Hopefully. Because I love
the thing is, I don't want beef. I don't want speculation. Like, that's just the truth. Is that it was their decision, not mine. But it's with no hard feelings. And I say that like so delicately.
There's plenty to go around.
Yeah.
Plenty of listeners to go around.
Yeah.
And what do you think of the new kid that they got that replaced you, Matt's replacement?
Kenny? Yeah. He's a good guy. He's very talented, and I think he's a very good asset.
Who do you think would win in a debate between you two?
Me and Kenny? I haven't honestly spent that much time with Kenny. I don't know. That's a really good question.
Does he have speech and debate experience?
I honestly don't know much about Kenny, so.
You would win in a cage match, fight to the death.
I guess I would.
You would. All right. There you go.
I think
shots
so,
fired.
But I don't.
Shots
but
fired.
I'm not trying to start beef with him because sometimes I'm always like pretty anti-conflict, anti-drama.
You want to be a people pleaser, and Jeff wants to make people uncomfortable. And
yes,
and,
sure.
Well, I mean, I'm a team player, but at the end of the day, I'm a soul entity, and I feel like if I could tear this whole squad apart and have everything for myself, that would be the dream. So that's what I'm trying to do here. Is end all of you guys.
Oh, so you're in here
one
pretending
by one, except
to help.
For Todd.
Yeah. Oh, Todd's your
taking
guy.
Taking Todd with me. We're going straight to Netflix after this once all this stuff's done. Awesome. Set the date. Matt King versus Kenny in the cage match.
We plan on me being back on Unfiltered for like
an
episode.
Oh, is that going to happen?
Yeah.
Have we talked about it?
We have talked about it. So
like recently.
It's not like I'll ever be in that room or in those seats again. Mm-hmm. But
I went to the studio. It's pretty nice.
Yeah, I haven't checked it out.
I love your role in our friend group of being a fucking asshole from New York who just stirs shit up. Because we need it. Everyone's too nice to each other. And
well, it's just communication, you know? I'd rather us have like those talks when we're talking shit to each other. Cause
right.
There is some truth that comes out, and then you can solve problems by like having that awkward conversation. You get it out of the way, and then like, you know, things
Wait,
are
better.
What
was the incident that happened where you guys were playing the game Hot Seat, and it was your idea, and then everyone got mad at each other, and someone got in the hot seat, and you were asking all the questions, you pissed them off, and then it was your turn to be in the hot seat, and then
everybody went hard on me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I think I know what you're getting at when Heath called me a clout chaser.
Oh. Wait, did he just ask you directly, like, are you a clout chaser?
He said something. He was like, what are your intentions or some shit like that? And I was like, my fucking intentions, motherfucker? What the fuck do you think this is, bro? We're supposed to play a stupid game. Yeah, shit got too real.
But were you there for this, Matt?
Sometimes
no,
it gets too
I just
real.
I heard about it.
But
because it
know,
caused a lot of tensions and people were steamed over the next few days.
At me?
Kinda.
Yeah, no, I just about that one thing because I've been in this game a while and like I love all you guys and I respect all you guys and my intentions were never real. Like I kid about like tearing you guys apart.
Yeah.
But I can see that would be what people would expect from me. You know, like I'm just in this for myself. And like, even though I'm saying it sarcastically, like it was nice to hear it, you know?
Yeah.
All right. Finally, somebody said it, you know, I'm happy he'd said that to me. Cause this was when I was fresh into the squad and all of a sudden this cool guy comes in getting all the chicks, making all the dough. Of course, people are going to have some stuff to say about me. I'm going to hate myself watching this back.
I think you have a really good sense of humility and I know who you are. Like, on and off camera.
And like us and as people would not associate or hang out with you if you actually were a fucking piece of shit.
Yeah.
Like, we wouldn't do that.
Yeah. Bro, I've been like successful. I've had money. I've been poor. I've been at rock bottom in jail. I've been, you know, like kind of famous, like known, like I walk down the street and get recognized and then like also jail and like up and down so many times that like I don't really give a fuck about any of this shit. Like genuinely, I know people say like I don't care about fame, I don't care about money. I genuinely don't care. Like I've been had ups and downs so much and it can get stripped from you at any moment. So I'm just riding the wave and I like that's why I like poking fun and messing with people because like nothing really matters at the end of the day.
Yeah, you know, that's a good outlook to have and I have nothing but love for you.
Thanks. Yeah, you guys are great, even though I fucking talk shit and I slap Mike in the face. Are you guys going to go looting?
No.
Power drill. Remember? Just
yes.
Take out the screws.
Yeah. Jeff, what's the best piece of advice you've ever been given?
Ah, oh, fuck. I don't know. There's so many things, Mike.
When you're presented with this, like a situation or a problem, is there a Jeff Wittek like school of thought that you're like, oh no, this is how I my
yeah.
Philosophy
yeah.
Of
what's
life.
The what's the Jeff Wittek mantra?
Nobody makes it out alive.
Whoa.
Wow.
We're all going to the same place. Oh, and another one that I like. So stupid. It's a Tame Impala.
Let It Happen?
No.
Eventually?
They have so many good ones, but eventually terrible memories turn into great ones.
Ooh.
Whoa.
Yeah, that one's good. Because I have a lot of horrible memories, but now that I look back at them, it's like, I'm happy I went through it.
Yeah, you know? I feel like I've like grown into that thought a lot. Too mm-hmm. is like I'm glad things happen. You know, don't cry because it happened. Smile because it did. What's the phrase?
Don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened.
Yes.
The one I think about a lot. When you look toward the sunshine, all the shadows fall behind you. What? That's
no,
a great
funny.
Quote.
Who
no,
taught
I
you that? Your karate teacher?
No, I feel like my guidance counselor had that like on a poster in her room.
Okay. Well. I'm just gonna fucking
no. We're just joking.
Yeah,
no, I know.
We're
joking.
Just riffing
no,
over
one.
Here. I don't know. I wasn't prepared for that question.
Why am I so easy to make fun of?
You just take the jokes well. I guess it's tough for everyone to be able to joke on themselves, and you are good at it. I don't know if it's from years and years and a lifetime of being bullied that you've gotten so good at it. No, I'm just kidding. You're a smart guy, and I don't know. I don't know what it makes people fun to make fun of. Because Matt's one of my favorites. You just call him a rat, and it's like something so dumb. But
I own it. Did you bring any cheese for me?
No.
Any nuts?
No, I was going to try not to say it today, but I came in saying it. It's the first thing I said off camera.
Well, I already knew it was coming. I actually was kind of brainstorming for Halloween costumes, and I was thinking, oh, what if I was like a rat? And
damn,
you were like
viral,
a mouse trap or something. Like, we should have played along with it, but...
Oh, yeah, like if Jeff was an exterminator and you were a rat.
Yes.
Yeah.
That would have been
damn,
pretty good.
That would have been good.
Hey, maybe next Halloween.
Mm-hmm. You always think of the best Halloween costumes on Halloween.
What was my costume this year?
I don't know. I didn't even pay attention. But there was no Halloween this year. I didn't do shit. I stayed home.
Well, I mean, at least I had a costume. I just had a small...
Life's depressing, you know? You just got to take this time, be creative, stay creative, stay making stuff. Don't fall into any bad habits.
Yes!
You know? You could stay home. You could down a six-pack of beers every night and get nothing done. Use this pandemic as an excuse to just become a fat, lazy mess.
Or you can become the best version of yourself.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Is that Houston?
Houston, yeah.
Oh, well, I'm from Dallas. So whatever. Nice to meet you, Jeff.
Same thing, close enough.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Tried.
Wait, what part of Long Island are you from?
Wrap it up.
We can wrap it up.
Get Brothers
Jeff,
Pizza.
Thank you so much for coming on Hoot and a Half. We loved having you. Guys, be sure to check Jeff out on anywhere and everywhere he's at on the internet.
Usually the trending page of YouTube every week. Check it
out.
Yeah,
I got an in over there.
Oh, you got someone?
Yeah, connection.
Yeah?
No. I don't know why they trend. I can't believe it when they trend some of the videos. Like, the last video I had violence, smoking cigarettes.
Alcohol.
Yeah,
it was nuts.
People were under the influence. Like, every
blood
rule we broke. But you know what? Maybe somebody at YouTube appreciates this adult content that we're putting out. Because, yeah, they're good to me. They're good to Hoot and a Half. So we love you, YouTube. We love you, Susan Wachowski. Whoever it is, thank you, guys.
All right, Jeff. All right, thank you.
Thank you, buddy.
And go fuck yourself. All right, bye, guys. Right. I'm out of here. I'm going to go hang out with Todd. I'm going to do some push-ups or something.
Hoot and a Half with Matt King and Mike Sheffer.